So what is ALS, you ask? Well, ALS Environmental is the service. It's basically the business located right here in Salt Lake City where one can bring a chemical for testing. And in this particular case, we are bringing a meth test that we took at a house to see if by chance this house has meth. So we're here at ALS Environmental here in Salt Lake City. And if I'm not mistaken, this facility services this region of the country. So for instance, Nevada, Colorado, if they wanted to test a house for meth, I believe they actually ship it here to Salt Lake City right here. And I think we're in West Valley or Taylorsville. Anyways, here's the situation. I got a call from a buddy of mine who knows that I fix and flip houses, invest in rentals, and also a real estate agent who helps people with investment properties. And he has two friends that purchased a home that they thought they were getting a pretty good deal. And maybe they're still getting a deal. It's yet to be seen, but we'll know more here in the near future. And basically, here's what happened. These two individuals got approached by a real estate agent that they know. This real estate agent said, hey, listen, there is a short sale on the market, at which point if you close on it, you can get a pretty good deal. And that part was true. It is a discounted property and they could get a pretty decent deal. However, it depends on what you're going to do with the home if it becomes a good deal or not. If they would have owner occupied the home, meaning they're going to move into the home, it's a pretty good deal. There's a pretty good discount there. But if they're going to flip it, then they need some profit in between what they purchase it for and what they resell it at for it to be a good deal. Obviously, if there's not enough profit due to the expenses of when you sell a house, then you might not have any profit left, right? So here's what happened. This real estate agent called these two guys and said, listen, there is a short sale. It's underpriced. My son wants to live in this community. He can't afford to get it right now, but in 30 days when he qualifies for the loan, he will be able to purchase this home. So if you guys buy the house now, then in 30 days, in approximately 30 days, my son will buy it off of you guys and you guys can make a little bit of a profit and then my son can live in this community and he doesn't have to go through the whole bidding war and competition of trying to beat people to get the home and he'll be happy and you guys will be happy because you'll have made some money. So that sounded grand and dandy, but unfortunately, this son decided he no longer wants the home. So he doesn't want to live in the home anymore. So now these two guys own the home. Well, here's the other hiccup. The original owners who lost the house basically had to sell it in a short sale because they were facing foreclosure. They didn't want to leave the home after they sold it. So the new owners, these two new guys that just bought it, had to go through the eviction process. And they had to evict these old owners because they were now the new owners. So going through the eviction process, the judge mandated a lockout, which means a sheriff will show up to the house and basically force the occupants to leave the home and lock them out. They call it a lockout. So for good reason, because they lock them out. So the sheriff went over there and locked out these previous occupants who have now sold their home, but they're still refusing to leave their home. So while the sheriff was doing the lockout, he came out of the home and told these two new owners, hey, listen, you guys probably want to test this house for meth. So that obviously puts a wrench into this particular transaction because here's why. Originally, these two gentlemen were going to sell it to the son with no real estate agents involved. With no real estate agents involved, they don't have to pay the expenses that one incurs when selling a home if they use real estate agents. So by not having to pay a real estate agent the commission, then they could sell it directly to the son and there would have been room for some profit. However, the son doesn't want the home anymore. So now they're considering putting it back on the market. If they put it back on the market, they're going to have to hire, most likely, a realtor to assist them in that transaction, which means now there's going to be a little bit of an extra expense on selling their home because now they have to pay a real estate agent. So the second hiccup is, we are here at ALS Environmental dropping off the meth test because now they need to know if this home has meth in it. If it does have meth, then meth isn't necessarily the most cheapest thing to remedy. It can be rather expensive. It's not the most expensive thing in the world to remedy, but it's also not the cheapest thing in the world to remedy. So if now they have to pay a real estate agent to help them sell, whatever commission that may be, whether they negotiate that commission, whatever it is, if it's that friend of theirs, whoever it may be, whether they have to pay a real estate agent now versus before they didn't, and if they now have to remediate the home for meth, then that could eat into what was already a smaller profit margin. And so the reason I'm sharing this with you is you definitely want to make sure you know your numbers really well. Unfortunately, they didn't know their numbers really well. They knew what they could sell it for to the sun, but they didn't really figure out what they could sell it to on the open market plus all of the fees. So by going into this transaction thinking they had their end buyer with no plan B, if this house tests for meth and if they decide to liquidate it immediately and use a real estate agent to do so, they may come out of this transaction in the negative. So they may have to consider keeping it now as a rental property, which they did not intend to do. They wanted to put their money into the deal and get their money back out immediately, but now their money may have to sit there for a while until there's some more equity in the deal before they can sell it. Now, here is another hiccup. We're in 2020. The coronavirus is amongst us, and a lot of economists are predicting that we are at the peak and about to go down. So if they hold the property as a rental and assuming that the market goes down, then they may have to hold this for 5, 6, 7 years before it comes back up. So they may want to hurry and liquidate, take a little bit of a loss today to get that money back so they can keep that money working on future transactions. I don't know what they're going to decide to do. Maybe it doesn't test positive for meth. We'll find out here shortly. But if it does, then it could put a little bit of a wrench into their profit margins. And it is a transaction that looked like it could have been an easy slam dunk in that they had an end buyer lined up, but as soon as that end buyer decided to back out, and this is again before we even heard from the police that, you know, there might be potential meth in there. Of course, we still have no idea. We're literally sitting here. You can see the building behind me, which is ALS Environmental. This is literally the place that you drop off the meth test that they do the meth results. And so we literally don't even know. It might be completely clean. Regardless, though, they've lost their buyer. So on that note, you're definitely going to want to make sure you do some good due diligence and consider all of the possibilities that could happen before you invest some money in a transaction that looks like a good deal, looks like a slam dunk, but then falls apart shortly thereafter. A lot of investors who are newer, and these share, these two individuals are not real estate investors by trade. They just thought there was an opportunity there to make a little bit of extra money. But they don't do real estate for a living. They don't invest in real estate for a living. Oftentimes you don't know what you don't know. So it's a good idea to ask individuals who may know of different scenarios that could play out so you can best be prepared to make the best decision possible moving forward. So now, due to the situation that they're in, their friend, who happens to be my mutual friend, has now called me to help get involved to see how we can basically save this transaction from being a loss. So obviously I'm here at ALS Environmental to figure out the first piece of the puzzle to make sure it doesn't have meth. If it doesn't, that's going to be a great thumbs up. If it does, then we're going to have to adjust and pivot at that time. Anyways, I wanted to share that story with you guys because this is basically a day in the life of a real estate investor. I find myself helping a lot of people. Sadly, I'm finding myself helping people after the fact when they need the help because they didn't know what they didn't know. And so because they're in a little bit of a bind, they start telling friends who then reach out to me and put us connected. And then I basically get involved to try and help them the best way possible to find the best ending scenario possible. So on that note, a good tip is if you're going to start to invest in something you're not too familiar with, for instance, real estate, then, you know, reach out to somebody who's maybe doing it regularly so that you can bounce some ideas off of them. I'd be happy to assist anybody if that was something that you wanted to discuss, a particular transaction, particular property. I would be happy to chat about ideas, kind of plant some seeds on ideas that could happen on those situations where you don't know what you don't know.